everyone. Lisa Haven here, and I've got a powerful report to share with you guys. As you know, today is election day, and I am praying President Trump comes through. We get the elections we want today, and we have everything. But obviously, us getting those results, we've already been told by mainstream media it's going to take a while, or at least by social media. But hopefully, we get surprised. But with that, we really need to know which direction our economy is going to be headed. If Joe Biden somehow manages to get in, go to lots more information on restricted on that. But if he somehow gets in and becomes president, then what on earth is going to happen to our economy? And personally, I don't think it's looking good. And under President Trump, what is our economy going to look like? So with that, I wanted to bring on an economic insider to kind of delve into what 2020, the rest of the year, and 2021 are going to look like economically. And with that, I'm bringing on Noble Gold Investments, Colin Plume. So are you with me over there?
Yes, Lisa, thank you. Yeah, no, an exciting day to be on your show. Obviously, I've been watching over the last few weeks, and there's a lot of things happening that could move the markets one way or another. And I think any way you want to look at it, obviously, the economy is in trouble. And it really comes down to how much stimulus, depending on who gets in office, is actually going to happen. Both presidents are obviously going to have stimulus packages. It just depends on the size of the stimulus package. I think if you look at Biden's package on a united front, if he becomes president, he will probably pass a $3 trillion stimulus package. That's what they've been talking about. If President Trump gets reelected, he will also do stimulus, but probably not on the same level as President Biden, just in terms of, you know, I think there's some people that are conflicted on how much stimulus we should be giving out there, because ultimately we pay for that stimulus. I know it seems like a good thing to get money up front, and it is good initially, but if this is a never-ending cycle of free money, if interest rates are going to stay low forever, which it affects all of us, it affects everyone to not be able to put any money in a bank and not get any return and have all this debt out there. Either way, stimulus is going to be one of the most important things that happens after this election. And then there's a few other things that'll happen that I think will affect the economy.
And I agree with the stimulus part, because technically that's called socialism when we're continually getting free money over and over again. And evidently we all pay for it out of our pocket in some way, shape and form, some way, shape or form. Now, you mentioned, you know, Biden will have a bigger stimulus. But here's the other thing we have to remember. If Biden does get in, he's also talked about massively raising taxes and locking down the country again, implementing a massive mask mandate. And so, in other words, he's going to cause so much chaos in the economy, break us down. But here's a little, how should I say, nugget of a stimulus to help you along under President Trump. Hopefully, I don't see further lockdowns under President. At least he said that he's not going to do a national lockdown of any sort. Thank God. And I really mean thank God. But I think that could attribute why, you know, Trump's is per se less or whatever, because he doesn't plan on crashing the economy. I think if Joe Biden gets in, we're screwed economically. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, I think either way, yeah, our economy has shifted in a lot of ways. You know, I just look at the day-to-day living of Americans. And, you know, one thing I want to look at on the positive side with all this that's happening is you see, like, the real estate market kind of across the country has been exploding. And I think more people are just, they're hunkering down in their houses. They realize they're not going anywhere. And so I think there's going to be a lot of U.S. buying, a lot of goods that are focused here in the U.S. But yes, I'm obviously very concerned about people not being able to go out to restaurants, people not being able to travel. I mean, these are tourism, hospitality. These are big job creators, sports, franchises. I mean, if we can't open up over the next few months, I think a lot of these people that had this as a second job, they worked at a stadium or all these things, they need this income to survive. Now, let's talk about taxes. Yes, I'm obviously very concerned about any kind of tax increase right now, because we're in a situation where the people that need money, the last thing they need to have to do is have to pay more money in taxes. People are struggling just to make ends meet. So creating some kind of tax reform right now to increase taxes federally would really stifle things, not only just individually, but as a business owner myself, These are things you really have to start to think about. The more taxes that business owners have to pay, the less inclined that they're going to want to hire. And there's already so many regulations on so many business owners already, so many different types of taxations. It's really just not, it's not an appropriate time to kind of talk about.
No. And the other thing is, you mentioned small business. I mean, that's what Biden's, you know, massive tax is going after, is the small businesses. And so you said, well, not only when you increase the taxes on small business, it always goes down to us, to the people where, okay, well, you're going to raise my taxes. Now I have to raise my prices. I have to cut employees. I have to take certain things overseas in order to make this work with my business. And this is what happens every single time. So you're absolutely right on that. That's why I want to encourage people, make sure you're diversifying your profiles, right? And go to noblegoldinvestments.com. Collins there is it, all his people, great people to talk to you, but we need to get our 401 converted to a Roth IRA where it's backed by gold, silver, precious metals, these things, because the economy is so upside down, topsy-turvy. And I know you're giving away this 1/10th ounce gold coin, American Eagle. It's pretty awesome, by the way. But anyhow, I know some of the ways that at least we can protect ourselves, no matter who gets in. Look, I already know that the economy is still unstable no matter what, because we're living in times that are worse than the Great Depression. And shall I add, I think 2021 is going to look worse economically than 2020.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to be able to climb out a lot of the holes, even though residential, I was saying real estate on the residential side is really kind of booming because people are working from home and they're realizing, okay, I'm going to have to be home more. I'm going to fix that garden and I'm going to do little things around the house to make it more suitable because I can't go anywhere. There's a lot, there's millions and millions of square feet of office space across the country that nobody's going to know what to do. I mean, that those spaces are going to go completely vacant. And the big issue with that is that that's real estate that's going to come back to the banks. That's property taxes that are not going to get paid. These are real strong underlying issues that make it very difficult for our economy to move forward. We're basically in the largest shift, I would say, since we moved industry out of this country, probably in the mid to late 70s. Right now is the biggest shift in our workforce that we've seen in a long time, because it's really changing how people are going to work, but it can't change quick enough. And so, unfortunately, I do think next year our economy is going to be in a bad position, regardless of whoever's in office. And being diversified and looking at different options are really important. Precious metals are doing well, not just because of the economy. Precious metals are doing, silver, for instance, is vital to where we're moving. Solar energy, people working from home, all these systems, these data centers that we're creating to hold all this data, they use silver there. So it's not just the fact the economy is not going well and people are diversifying here. It's that a lot of these metals are used in industries that are moving us towards the future. So there's a lot of fundamentals there that people need to look out for. And that's the key to investing. You want to invest in something that you think is going to go over time, go well. And I think if people, especially silver, people look at silver right now, I think they'll be surprised how many uses are going to be in the future and are going to continue to grow with time.
And I'm going to throw these articles up there to back what you're saying. Here's this first one, mining.com, gold price to climb regardless of election results, analysts said. Deaconherald.com, gold prices gain as COVID cases surge. And I thought this was interesting. Kitco.com, is silver the next Bitcoin? So, I mean, we have some good news in the fact that, you know, we've got the price of gold going up. We've got crazy cool things happening with silver and precious metals. Again, that's why I have just been saying since I've known you and for the past year, make sure you have something else in another area. So how can you at Noble Gold Investments help people in an economic situation like this?
Yeah, well, a lot of people have lost jobs. They have an old 401k. Those old 401ks can be moved into traditional IRAs, or they can be moved into Roth IRAs. So that's something we can help you with. And we do all that paperwork for you. You can do it in-house, and you can move it into gold and silver. A lot of people call us and say, well, I have, you know, a few hundred thousand. I want to do some in gold and silver. Absolutely. You can do a portion of that. And that's a great thing too, because let's say you do a portion of that and then you find a new job. Well, when you find that new job and that 401k that you have with that new employer, that 401k is not going to be in gold and silver. So guess what? Now you've put some in gold and silver. And now you got this new job that you're going to be investing in the stock market. So you have some different assets. Hopefully you have a roof over your head, some real estate. So you got a few things in the pie. And so you're not so stuck on one investment. And that's the key right now, because even though the economy hasn't been strong, the stock market has been very strong, but we don't know how long that's going to be. So if that's where you have the majority of your money, and we see that big collapse like we did in 2008, that could hurt you pretty substantially in terms of your portfolio. So I think the key is just looking at the whole pie of what you have, getting information on different investments. You know, maybe gold and silver is right for you, and just making sure that you're not, don't put all your eggs in one basket, because that's really how a lot of people get hurt when things turn around and they go negative.
Oh yeah, I agree. And if you guys want information on that, you can check it out at noblegoldinvestments.com. With that, what are your concluding thoughts? You know, it's election day. What are your concluding thoughts with everything going on?
Yeah, the first thing I would say, don't panic. That's the thing that happens a lot of times. After every election, there's this panic that kind of sets in. And I think panic investing is the worst type of investing. I think the most important thing to do is to look at it, you know, health and your life and your family are the most important things. So I would say take your time with everything. Look at all of your options. But in terms of next year, 2021, my prediction is that, and a lot of people have much bolder predictions, but I think gold's going to hit 2,000, 250 next year. And I think silver is poised to break 40 next year from where it's sitting today. I think the fundamentals are there for those two numbers. This year, interesting, with all gold and silver going up, this has been the lowest buying of central banks of gold in the last 5 years. So with all this run-up, we still haven't seen that typical central bank, Russia, China, India, they've been actually sort of dormant. I think they have a lot of expenses with COVID going on right now. So I think next year, central banks are going to jump into the fold with all this retail buying. And I think that's going to help boost the price of metal. So I think we're going to see a nice uptick in gold and silver next year. And that's my prediction for metals.
Perfect. And how can people contact you and all of that?
NobleGoldInvestments.com, or they can call us. We're a US-based company. If they want to talk to a live person, they can call us at 877-646-5347.
Perfect. Well, thanks again for coming on the broadcast. We're in prayer today over this election. Please pray with me. God can work miracles through everything that's going on. So let's all pray that everything pans out and President Trump gets into office. And if we don't know today or tomorrow, we're just going to pray that we know ASAP. Anyhow, I love all of you. Thanks again for tuning in. That was Colin Bloom, and I'm Lisa Haven. And don't forget, all the information is in the description box below. Thanks again. I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.